The former top aide to Vice President Mike Pence is slamming President Trump's response to the coronavirus pandemic and publicly endorsing Joe Biden. CNN's own Jake Tapper broke this story for us. Olivia Troye, who was a Homeland Security advisor to the Vice President and his lead staffer on the White House Coronavirus Task Force, released a video earlier today. She says President Trump doesn't care about anyone else but himself. We're joined now by the Vice President's National Security Advisor, retired Lieutenant General Keith Kellogg. General Kellogg, thanks so much for joining us. You and I have known each other for almost 30 years, since the first Gulf War, when you were in the 82nd Airborne. I was CNN's Pentagon correspondent. Let's discuss what's happening today, because it's very dramatic. I want to play a little clip for you and our viewers of what Olivia Troye, a woman you know well, is saying about her experience of the coronavirus task force.
Towards the middle of February, we knew it wasn't a matter of if COVID would become a big pandemic here in the United States. It was a matter of when. But the president didn't want to hear that because his biggest concern was that we were in election year and how is this going to affect what he considered to be his record of success. The truth is, he doesn't actually care about anyone else but himself.
Very strong words, General Kellogg. How do you respond to that?
Well, I think Olivia's comments are egregious. They're flat wrong. In fact, I've got a copy of it, and you all have got a copy of it now. When she left the organization in the end of July, she talked how valiantly everybody was working, and that we were an inspiration to her and everything we had done. The simple fact is, what she's saying is not true. I've been through every single task force coronavirus meeting. I've been in the Oval with the president when we met with Tony Fauci, or Bob Redfield, or Stephen Hahn. We've been in those meetings, we've talked about it, and the president has repeatedly said, we're trying to get it right for America, and we're trying to get it right for people. He said he wants to get people well. That's the reason, Wolf, he's pushed so hard on Operation Warp Speed, on getting a vaccine, and he's got the three right now in phase three trials with the Pfizer, with the AstraZeneca, and with the Moderna. And we think we're getting ready to finish those phase three trials up, and then it goes to the Data Monitoring and Safety Board for them to come up with the efficacy and safety and get that out going forward, the vaccines out. And we're already producing today management at risk or monitoring the flow of the vaccine. We're producing it right now. So the minute we get the go-ahead from the FDA on the UA, we can start going out in shooting people with the vaccine.
Right,
and I think we've done a lot.
We all hope that vaccine comes very quickly. It's safe and effective, and let's hope for the best. But let's get back to what this woman, Olivia Troye, is saying. I want to show you and our viewers a few of the pictures of this official. She's sitting there right behind the vice president in these meetings with you, Dr. Fauci, and a bunch of others. Clearly, this is someone who was in the room for so many of these conversations. Why do you think she's now saying these awful things about the president? She's not saying awful things about you or other members of the coronavirus task force. She's specifically pointing to the president, saying he's only interested in himself.
Well, that's not true. He's not just interested in himself. He's interested in the nation. And the only thing I can make the assumption, and it happened today, is now she's a Republican for Biden. She wants Vice President Biden to win the election. That's pretty clear. But what she's saying is wrong, and I don't think she should say things that are just not true. I've never heard the president say that, and I've been in all of those meetings that are there. He's never said these comments about downplaying the virus, how important it is. He's talked to the doctors. He's got their impressions and their attitudes. He's let them go forward, and he's kept a very positive attitude about it. He's getting criticized for, among other things, having a very positive attitude. That's what I want leaders to do. I saw it in the military, I saw it in the business world, I saw it now in the government. You want a leader out there that's very positive, that keeps the morale up. But at the same time, we're working through and trying to get this thing solved.
Well, let me ask you, because you know she's not the only former Trump administration who has now emerged not only to endorse Biden, but to say awful things about the president of the United States. There's a whole bunch, and you've seen all the accusations in the Bob Woodward book, for example. How do you respond to all these individuals? Most of them, you know well, you worked with them, but now they're really condemning the president.
I just disagree with them, totally, because I've been with the president now going almost into 6 years, and I've been with him since the campaign started, through the last 4 years, and I've seen him operate behind closed doors, or as John Bolton said, in the room. And what they say is just not true. And I don't know what, if it's a personal animus, they don't like his style. I don't know what it is. But the fact is they're wrong. He is for the American people. He is working for the American people. That's why we're pushing a vaccine so hard, faster than it's ever been produced before, ever in history, to get it out to the American people. And he's very, very concerned about that.